In this video, we're going to talk about how to replace the Teflon sealing rings on a direct injected fuel injector. So this particular injector is from a BMW N55 engine. So it's like an early, maybe 2011, 2012, 335i in this case, but was in a lot of other platforms. And in fact, this Teflon sealing style is pretty consistent amongst a lot of different brands. And so this process is going to be pretty similar brand to brand, car to car. The tooling might change just a little bit, but again, a lot of similarities. So let's go through that process. So here I've got a bunch of the specialty tools and supplies that we need to do this. So we need our injector. We've got to remove this. There might be a specialty tool to pull this. A lot of them use what looks like a small slide hammer that fixes to the fuel pipe threads right here on the end, and then that helps you remove it. But that, again, might vary car to car with what you're working on. So we get this out, and what we can see, there's some buildup down here. We're going to clean that off, and we're going to take this Teflon seal as well as this decoupler off. So here I've got a bunch of the specialty tools to go through this process. And so the process is really that I need to cut off this Teflon seal. It's pressed on and fitted to the injector. It's a very specific diameter, and they are not reusable. So if I take this injector out of the engine, I've got to replace this seal and this decoupler right here. Removing this is going to look a little bit different based on the engine. A lot of these BMW platforms, there's a small specialty tool that goes on the fuel pipe end on these threads, and it acts as a small slide hammer. And so that's part of this kit right here, that this would get held onto this adapter like that, and then you can set it up, use the slide hammer function to pull the injector out. They're not terribly difficult to remove, but there is some tension and resistance because of how close the tolerance is and fit at this Teflon and at this end. Remember that this has to seal combustion, and so it's got to be a really tight fit and be able to withstand high temperatures. So in this kit, once I get the injector out, I've then got to cut off the Teflon seal. And so this little set of what looks like pliers helped me do that. And so these have kind of a sharp edge at these two points. There's a small piece of nylon to help protect the tip of the injector. And so I'm just going to put that on like that. Try to get it set up where we can see. And I squeeze, and there's a small stop that I can make adjustments for based on the injector. And my goal is to just kind of pick at it a couple times until I get the edge of it off like that. And so then I can keep going with the tool, or I can just kind of pick it with my nail and pull that off, right? And so there I've got my Teflon seal. I've got it removed, and I can throw that away. If I didn't have this tool, I could take a razor blade and very carefully make a slit and take that Teflon seal off. I do want to be really careful about that. I don't want to nick the bore, or rather the body of the injector, because if I put any kind of burr or edge on that, it could harm the process of installing the Teflon seal or harm the cylinder head when I put that back into the bore in the head. So just a note there to be cautious. Once I've got that off, I've then got to remove this decoupling ring. And so that has just a small edge on it. I push that and can take that off by hand. And then I want to clean up these surfaces before I reinstall things. You can use rubbing alcohol or a little bit of brake clean. And take caution not to rub just the tipped end of it. We don't want to push any of that carbon into the holes where the fuel comes out. They're very, very small, and I could potentially create some issues if I create a blockage. Once I've got that cleaned up fairly well, I want to give a nice clean surface for my new seals. So there, we've got it cleaned up. Looks pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and install my decoupler first. It just goes on the outside and pops down. There it goes. And so now I've got to set out to install this new Teflon seal ring. So this seal ring is quite small. It is Teflon, and so it has the ability to stretch to a point. But as we saw when we went to cut and tear this one to remove the old one, they are quite brittle, and so they do tear easily. And so there's, again, some special tools here. this piece right here, this cone, is to help me install the Teflon seal. So I put my seal on just like that, and I'm going to continue to push it. I can work it just a little bit with my fingers. I want to be careful not to indent it with my nail. And then I'm going to use a special tool. So this one is actually from a different kit. This is not part of the 2250 kit. This was from another kit that I purchased on Amazon. You can get away with using some of these little mandrels and dies to do this process, but they don't fit very well. And so if you look at the service information from BMW, the BMW specialty tool looks much like this, right? And so this is gonna help us. The end of it is plastic, so it's not gonna damage the Teflon. I can load the cone somewhat like that. And I'm gonna line it up with the cone at the edge and just slowly push the seal. It's gonna go over the tip of the injector. I'll keep going until it is in the chamfer right there where it's going to stay. When that's done, I can take the end of this off the tool. The cone gets stuck, and so the tool's got a little plunger there. I can push the cone back out and reset that tool for next time. So now that I've got that on, you can see that the diameter of it is quite a bit larger than the bore. And so now my next step is that I've got to essentially reform that Teflon seal and make it smaller so that it will fit in the engine in the cylinder head where it's supposed to go. And so to do that, they've got these three little mandrels that are A, B, and C. There's a secondary tool that looks much like this one that didn't fit in my application, that one that came with this. And so I'm gonna use these mandrels. They've worked just fine. One of the ways that you can size out the mandrel is to take the end, you've gotta pay attention, the smallest end, these are tapered. And so they're basically like the cone, just in reverse. They're gonna try to take that Teflon seal and form it down. And so the smallest end, if that fits the tip of your injector, then that's gonna help you get where you need to be, right? And so they go from largest to smallest. So the A1, I push that on. I can push it down pretty easily. I don't wanna go past the seal, so I'm watching the edge on the top right here. I get the A set, let it sit for a second. I can take that back off. I'm gonna go to B. A little bit more resistance there. If there's a lot of resistance, we just push it a little bit and wait a second, let that Teflon seal be compressed a bit, and then continue. Again, I don't want the seal to pop out the top. Because it's tapered, if I go too far down, I could rip it going backwards. So be cautious. All done with the B, and then go on to C. And on the BMW service info, it does say not to lubricate this. So even if it feels like there's a little bit of resistance, the service info says do not add any kind of lubricant at this step of the process. So that one there, the C1 does stop at the collar, this edge of the injector. And you can see the end of it right there is almost flush. And so with that, it's gonna be set. So now when I take that one back off, you can see now it's pretty much all flush with the body of the injector. And so now this one's ready to be installed. That's a rundown on how to replace the Teflon seals on a BMW N55 fuel injector with the CTA 2250 kit. Again, all this process is really similar across models and different makes. These Teflon seals are pretty much the standard. And so this video could be helpful on a lot of different vehicle platforms.